This recording is called How to Be Happy Again, and this is Ron Farmer talking to you. It has long been known that deep within our being, we are always happy, always content, to a degree beyond imagination and measure. This inner space, this sanctuary, is known to some as the kingdom of heaven within. To others, it is Satchitananda, which means being, awareness, bliss. It can be sought after with the Buddhist chant of Om Mani Padme Hum, the Lord's Prayer of the Christians, or the Vedantic So Hum, repeated with the in and out breath. There are many names for this centre of pure, lasting, unsullied happiness, and there are thousands of pathways to reach there. When we taste a little nectar of this sublime inner joy, there is a feeling of coming home at last, to one's natural self. We all know about this happiness of pure gold, for at times we sense its presence, hidden behind a veil in every cell of our being. There is a yearning to recapture that feeling of all being well with the world, an experience of true freedom from fear, wanting, and even time. But how can we be sure that our true nature is lasting, unbounded joy? Look at it this way. When we are feeling robust and full of good cheer, nobody is worried or surprised. In contrast, people are concerned about us when grief and sorrow make shadows in our life. "Why are you not happy?" they ask, caringly. There is a different form of logic which also supports the idea. It's called listening to the pearl divers. Let me explain. If I wanted to find out the best place to dive in the ocean for pearls, I would go to the most successful pearl diver and ask him. Being generous, he would tell me, "Dive here. This is where you find the best pearls." I'd be foolish to ignore his advice and go poking around in the shallows, far away from where he had said. It's the same when we are searching for happiness. The pearl divers, in this sense, are the giants of history whose happiness, love and contentment were beyond measure. People like Gautama Buddha, Lord Jesus, Krishna, Rumi, St. John of the Cross. All of them said, "You have to dive here for the pearls. Search inside yourself. There you will find treasure beyond imagination." Why should we look elsewhere when the pearl divers have shown us the way?